Hello everybody, welcome to UroChannel. You wouldn't believe what I got in the mail. It's a box full of sperm. And in this video, I am going to show you what I do with it, because this is part of the biannual proficiency test that I have to pass in order to do all these sperm counts. So let's go. Okay, so let me unbox this thing. Here's a letter with the instructions. That's from the lab, and I usually also get a sheet where I can write in my results. And this is the sperm. It's in two small samples that I have to heat up before processing it. And here are some slides, and I have to dye those so that I get to see the form, the morphology of the sperm. So we'll do that later. I will have to use some very special equipment. This is a so-called positive displacement pipette, and it works with this little one that I have to slide into a bigger one, like this. And this is for very thick liquids. So I just suck the sperm up with this one, and I can press it out with the little one inside, and then I get the exact measurement and the exact amount of sperm that I want to have. Morphology is first, which means my first sample has to be mixed to distribute the sperm evenly within the sample. This has to be done very thoroughly to avoid false readings. I need 10 microliters for this. And I put a cover slide on this. That's it. Let's have a look what's inside. I will have to count the sperm, and I'm showing you what I see on my computer screen here. So you can see what I can see. And my task is just to have a look in one of those fields. So this is one field, so-called, and I have to count the sperm that are within this field. And I have a counter, as you can hear, and it's around 10 to 15 sperm per field. So now that I have had a first impression of how the sample looks, I just go to my smart booklet over here, and I just look up how much I have to dilute the sample. And when there are 15 to 40 sperm per field, I will have to dilute it with 1 to 10. And I'm using a special kind of, we say it in German, a puffer. It's a buffer. Buffer solution, WHO buffer it's called. And I'm going to use 1 in 10 and dilute the sperm sample with that. So this is how it looks like. I'm going to use 180 microliters of this. And I just vortex the sample, I swirled it around to distribute the sperm evenly. And this is 20 microliters. And now it's 180 microliters of this WHO buffer. And I put it in here together with the sperm. I can't stress this point enough. I have to mix the sample all of the time to distribute the sperm evenly, because this is key for passing the exam. Now it's time for counting, and I'm using this Neubauer improved counting chamber. You can't see it, but there are very small squares on this chamber. You can only see it in the microscope. I'm going to show you in a minute. And I'm putting two samples of the solution on the slide, and I'm counting two times in order not to make any mistakes. This is how it looks like. You see all those squares, and within the squares, there are the sperm distributed. As you can see here, like here are two sperm, three sperm. And when I count through one of those bigger squares, I can see like 6, 7, 8 sperm. And I just quickly skim through them. This is evenly distributed. Okay, so what I have to do now, I have to count the sperm within all of those 25 squares that are on the slide. Here you can see the grid a little better. So all of the 25 I will have to count. Grid B had 69 sperm. Grid A had 84 sperm. Will this be good enough? Well, we just have to look it up. So let's go back to our table. So this is 69 plus 84, which is 153. And if it's between 144 to 156, the acceptable difference will be 24. So that's good enough. So we take it. I quickly did the math with a formula that accounted to the amount of WHO buffer I was using, the number of squares that I was counting, and the two grids that I counted. And this came down to 7.65 million sperm per milliliter. Now let's move on to morphology. The sperm on these slides are invisible to the microscope, so I have to put some color on it. And this is the system I'm using. It's called the DivQuick system. There are two dye and one fixation solution. And I quickly dip the slide into these solutions. And then after drying them, I will be able to see them under the microscope. So first some fixation solution. Now it's color A. And then in the end, I'm going to rinse this very carefully. This is distilled water, by the way. Whoa, this was exhausting. I was waiting for the slides to dry, and then I thought I just quickly process sample B. But it turned out that it didn't work out and I had to do it all over again. So half an hour later, here we are with the dried slides. Now I'm going for morphology. This is how it looks like after the DivQuick has dried. And I'm not sure whether you can see that this one is a normal sperm. The screen is not that sharp, but the head is very even. And then we've got a middle piece that's just below the head, which is not remarkable. And we've got a nice tail going up here. Actually, it looks like there are two tails, but the one going here, that's the one from this sperm. This is not a normal sperm. The head is very unevenly shaped, and you've even got some discoloration going on here. Here you can see the acrosome cap. That's the black dot on top. That's the one that connects to the egg of the woman, and then the sperm gets inside the egg. Here we got it's like a purple dot. That's the head of this sperm. This is not normal. The other ones are not normal either, but it's normal not to be normal sperm-wise because the norm is 4%. If you've got 4% normally shaped sperm, then everything's okay. That's normal. So I'm going to count 200 of those and then we'll see what comes out of it. Okay, so after morphology, what's left is motility. And for this, I don't have to be in the lab. It's all online and I'm going to download a video. This is the platform where I'm going to put in my results. As you can see here are the tests that I've done already. The last one, I don't know if I checked whether I passed it. Looks quite good, I think. What does it say? Certificate. Yep. Aha, I passed. Concentration passed, morphology passed, motility passed. This was all in November. So no worries about that because I just have to pass once per year. So I am fine for today, even if I don't pass. But I don't think that has happened before. We'll see. This is how the video looks like. There are two samples, sample A and sample B, and I'm going to process each one of them by using my counter here. So let's go. So what's my approach? I'm just looking at an area of the screen which goes along here, and I don't care very much about the rest of the screen. And then I'm counting the fast moving sperm first. Then I'm going to look at the ones who are moving, but which are not progressive, like this one here. It's just wiggles, but it's not progressive. And then I'm going to look at the sperm, which don't move at all. That's it. Well, that was exhausting, especially with doing the video at the same time. Here are my results. I hope I'll pass. So wish me luck. See you in the next video. Bye bye.